don't help these people. Just go to your neighbor. We all neighbors now. Go over there with some Lowry seasoning. Go over there with some lemon pepper sauce. Go on over there and help them out. All right? Don't be like that. Because when the world opens up, these people should help these people. We help you now, you help us later. Think about it. A lot of us right now, you just filed your taxes. You finna get a stimulus check. You, oh my gosh, you're doing wonderful right now. You know, these people have bought up all the shrimp and crab legs that normally these people buy. Help us out. Do not spend all your money. My people, my new friends, don't buy up all the crab legs and shrimp and stuff you can't even pronounce. Scallops. You can't even pronounce it. You shouldn't be buying it trying to cook scallops.
Doctor Manus, got your times, because I know you hate the journal.
All right, Mr. Young. Thank you.
Mr. Young, why so formal? We got company.
Oh, yeah. Oh yeah.
Oh yeah.
Oh yeah. Okay. Black ass Mr. Kool-Aid. Oh yeah.
Oh yeah.
What's going on, right, man? We back. Hey, I hope everybody had a good country holiday or whatever you want to call it, but we back. We had a nice little vacation. How you doing, Ty?
Hey, I'm good, man. You just go Juneteenth. Damn the fourth now, huh? You don't get that by the fourth no more. You done switched up. Oh my gosh.
Whoa!
All the way through. Hey man, great times right here on Actin Funny. It's your man, comedian Tight Mike, alongside my baby boy right here, Essex O'Brien, actor Essex O'Brien, South Florida very own. One time for the U, two time for the FSU. How about that? And one time for them family Rattlers. How about that right there? Florida Gators, if there many, if there be any, got to show you love too, man. And all other colleges in between, Florida Atlantic, Florida Memorial. Hey, all the cards in this great state of Florida.
I guess we got to represent the night since we got a night coming in.
We definitely got UCF.
We never talk about them like that. You know what I'm saying? Like, right.
But you know, I got some great friends that went to UCF, man. I got some good buddies that went to UCF. And Orlando don't get the hype that they should. Dante Culpepper actually went to UCF.
He was pretty good.
He was pretty good. My main man, Michael Gaines from my hometown. Definitely two times for FSU. We see you. One time for the Rattlers.
No,
Gabriel.
Times for FSU.
Oh, yeah, man. UCF got a lot of people, too, man. Hey, anyway, if you did not go to college, went to junior college like I did, some people start out slow. Hey, maybe you just went to Sunday school. Maybe you went to DeVry or Everest. Long as you went to school. And even if you own a pencil, we just want to shout you out tonight. You just own a pencil. And you try to read.
Trade schools, plumbing schools, nail techs.
All right.
You know what I'm saying?
AC fixers. All them people, man. There you go. Hey, man, it's a brown cup night, brown liquor, red cup night, I should say. See, I'm already tripping. Red cup, brown liquor night tonight because, bro, we got some superstardom on the show tonight, baby. We got some heat on Actin Funny tonight, man. As always, just want to let you come on in. Little something for the ladies. I know my man is married with a family, but every time I put that picture up, I got three comments about this dude that's coming on. Oh, pretty boy. Pretty boy on the show tonight.
Yeah, normally we have all these pretty women on here for the fellas, but now we got a little dark chocolate for the ladies.
Got to do something for the ladies, man. Had to show a lot of love. One of your acting buddies, man, is a former athlete, all-around great guy, family man. But he's definitely the new Morris Chestnut. He's chestnutish, if you will. Little Tyresean, if you will.
If we ask nicely, and maybe if we put his Cash App up, maybe he'll take his shirt off for the ladies. I don't know.
No. Hey, we got to let the ladies do that. We had to let the ladies comment on that. I'm just saying. I need the brother to know.
But I first started taking notice of this brother maybe about 4 or 5 years ago. Just, you know, social media. The algorithms put people together, you know, because we both actors. And I just really liked the way he was representing, the way he was getting himself out there, the way he was attacking the business, similar to myself when I was a little young boy coming up in this game, you know what I'm saying? Reps for his family, shows his family much love, which we as family men appreciate. So I was definitely happy that we could get him on the show today, you know what I'm saying? So should we go ahead and bring him in?
Hey, man, don't let the ladies wait any longer. Don't make the ladies wait.
Well, let me tease them a little bit. Let me tease them and give them a little something. We're going to show y'all this man's work because, you know, coming out of the Florida region, if there was somebody asked me some of the top five people who I think are destined for big things in this industry, Troy would be right at the top of the list. And I'm about to show you why. Y'all pay attention.
Can I help you guys?
Joshua Fisher?
Yeah, that's me.
We need to talk to you about Bria Isaac.
Is there a problem?
There's quite a few incident reports that would indicate otherwise.
Look, I know we had our problems. I had my problems. But I would never do that.
He's an alcoholic.
Where were you on Thursday afternoon?
I was here.
How long have you been here?
A week or so.
Can your friend verify that?
Yeah, I mean, yeah, work right now, but for sure.
Okay, we'll be in touch.
I'm telling you, do not try me.
No, you don't try me.
No, listen, I'm tired of this.
You're
bitch.
Disrespectful.
I come home.
You know
I come home. We don't have sex. You don't make dinner.
Oh, really? Yeah, you don't do shit.
Oh, really? You don't do
well,
shit.
Because you're out fucking somebody else. So what do you want me to
but
do?
That's because you ain't handling your business.
Man, fuck off.
That's because you ain't handling
back
your
up,
business.
Back up.
If you don't do what you
back
want to do,
up.
Another bitch will.
I like that.
Yeah.
I like how you
good.
Think. Okay, okay.
And I know I like my baby to look good and all.
You know I gotta represent.
But if you could just cut back on the haircuts.
Say what?
Maybe even cut it yourself. Then that's easily over $200 if you could save a month.
Yeah, okay. Okay, says the woman that just came here with not one, not two, not three, but four. Four bags of new clothes and new shoes. I have an idea. How about you cut back on your shopping?
Huh?
Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Troy D. Williams. What's going on, brother?
Hey, what's good, man? What's going on, fellas?
What's up, bro? Chilling, man. Hey, bro, I see you. I see you already. You've been in the work. You've been in the gym. You've been working out. You've been eating your raw eggs. And your skin all smooth and stuff, dog. I'm saying, that ain't no makeup either. I see you, dog. I see you. Family man, brother. My first question, of course, is welcome. First of all, welcome to Acting Funny. But my first question
God
is, skin so smooth like that, dog.
You said how I keep it so smooth?
Keep your skin smooth.
Yeah, so I use this great line called Artistry. You know what I'm saying? If anybody needs it, they can holler at my wife. And, you know, like for the cleanser, you know, so it's a process, right? You know,
right.
So I have the cleanser, the foam cleanser. We do that. Then I apply this eye cream on there. You know what I'm saying? Because I used to have these really dark bags under my eyes.
Okay.
So, it just keeps me smooth, man. It keeps my skin shiny and healthy.
Okay.
And college guys
don't want to be looking like Charlemagne the God in a little bit, y'all.
He ain't gonna lose his medal in, is he? He's gonna be all right, man. That's an off the wall question. I know this boy crazy. It's off the wall question, I know, but a lot of times, man, guys, they're afraid to ask questions like that. It wasn't until I got on TV, so I found out about makeup and foundation and things like that. But they're also skin routines. But those are questions that fellas are scared to ask. We ain't gonna go buy no makeup, but we want to look nice. So I would start out there. Your skin, I know you're younger than us, but your skin seems to be a little glistening, my dude. I ain't trying to holler at you, dog, but your shit clean.
Hey, I appreciate that, man. I appreciate that.
No problem.
Hey, sure, man. The black of the berry. The black of the berry.
One thing I definitely wanted you to do, man, is just kind of tell the people, like, how'd you get started in the industry? What made you start wanting to get down this path?
Yeah, so I'll give them the short story of that. So basically, I was playing semi-pro football, you know, after college, after graduating from UCF and Go Knights. I heard the shout out up there. But yeah, I was in the corporate world, you know, but I played sports my entire life. Basketball was my first love, you know, so I was moved up to varsity at the end of my sophomore year from JV. And then my 11th grade and 12th grade year, you know, varsity. So my mom wouldn't let me play football in high school. She always feared I was going to get hurt. And because I had really good grades, she was like, no, you're going to get in college academically, you know. So I couldn't play until after I was able to make my own decisions, you know. So I played semi-pro. And then once we won a championship in my second year, and then it was kind of time to hang it up because I had went to one of those NFL regional combines, right? And that's when I seen that I was 26 at the time, you know, so I was a little bit older. And you had some of those dudes where they were like 20, 21, you know, right out of college, like in their prime, you know. So I didn't do good at the regional combine. Let's just put it that way. Not as good as I thought I was going to do. And then for me, it was closure, though. It was like, all right, at least I went for it, though. So yeah. After, you know, fast forward a little bit after not having football, I'm like, I don't have any athletics in my life for the first time ever, you know. So I needed something to fulfill that adrenaline rush, you know, and acting was something I always wanted to do even as a child, you know. So I just said, hey, you know, let's go for it. And, yeah.
Doesn't Omari Hardwick have a similar background? He was in football before he went acting.
I believe so.
Yeah, I believe. Yeah, it sounds very similar.
I got you. Hey, my man, you've been in a lot of small projects, but I definitely want to start off the top of the show here by recognizing you actually won a prestigious award there, young man. Southeast is an actor of the year.
It was best actor. It was the best male actor, yeah, for the Southeast Regional Film Festival. Yes. Appreciate that, man. Appreciate that.
Yeah, I got a shout that I read that about you. Shouts out to your hometown, man, Bradenton, Florida. What movie did you win the best actor?
So the interesting thing was it was a new category that they did. It was based on demo reels. So you were able to put together, like, you know what I'm saying, all your best work, and it had to be like under 2 minutes long or whatnot. So it was a combination of quite a few projects. So, yeah, I actually won, man. It was huge. It was a huge milestone in my career. You know, not that in Essex, he knows, you know, as an actor, I mean, we don't need awards to define us, you know, because we do the work just for the love of it. But it's also an indication that we're going in the right direction, you know, to get recognized for what it is you're doing. So that was very special. A night I will never forget.
Yeah. How long ago was that?
That was 2019. Like,
okay. 2 years.
Like 2 years ago. Yeah.
2 years. I see you letting your hair grow up because I saw in the clip you had your hair down low, all smooth like Mars Chestnut. I ain't gonna say nothing, dog. I'm the comedian, but I definitely have a lot of great questions. Again, shouts out to you, man, for winning that award. Also, man, your hometown, Bradenton. Go right here, Essex question.
Yeah, correct me if I'm wrong. That particular film, that was the one with you and Marie in, right? You produced that, correct?
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, that was the first film that I produced. A Positive Outcome. That was huge, man. And shout out to Maria Levee. She was actually a co-producer on that one. So we actually produced it together, and we got selected into a lot of film festivals. And now we're actually in negotiation for a distribution deal for it. So, you know, the sky's the limit. You know, when you take a leap of faith and you're passionate about what you do and you work with passionate people, you know, anything can happen.
And that's good, man. Congratulations, brother. Don't forget us. Don't forget us. Don't forget us, dog. As we will not forget you. Essex mentioned right there, producing. Do you have anything upcoming now that you think about producing, directing, or are you a writer as well? Tell the folks a little bit about what you do.
Yeah, so I actually got into the producing side. It was funny. It was right before the pandemic. You know, things that kind of slowed down a lot. And I was like, you know what? I want to have some creative control over my own content. So currently what I'm producing is my own talk show, Limelight Conversations. And, you know, I'm able to have these one-on-one intimate conversations with people who are successful in different walks of life, different industries. And it just started off as a way for me to bring inspiration to people in dark times. You know, like when we went through the pandemic, people were hopeless. People were fearing like, hey, we don't know what tomorrow holds. You know, so I'm like, let me just start let these people tell their stories. And, you know, shout out to all the guests who've been on my show. You know, I'm going to have Essex on there as well. Me and him have to coordinate something. But, you know, they come on there and just share their story. And through their story, you know, people are getting inspired and people are really loving it. So my goal is we're just wrapping up season one. My goal is to get a distribution deal on that for season two and to be fully funded. And we're going to get that.
Yeah, that's what's up. That's what's up. As I was saying when I was introducing you, Troy, one of the things that I really appreciated about you even before we met was how you incorporate your family and bring your family along into what you're doing. You just posted the pictures about the vacations, and you know, your sons are involved in sports just like my sons. So talk a little bit about that, you know, how that balance works in with the acting and how that support system keeps you going. Because I know it's probably similar to me, man. Everything kind of revolves around that. So how are you guys balancing that?
Yeah, man, that's a great question. And I do have to say, man, your son's he's a beast, man. I'm like, I was looking at him, man. He got Steph Curry range already. I'm like, man, that's it.
if y'all can hear it in my voice, I'm really like, I'm struggling right now. Because, yeah, it was a long weekend. But thank you very much. You did pretty good.
But yeah, man, I mean, I'm sure just like you know, through our family, you know, is where we find true inspiration. You know, our family providing a better life, you know, for them is really what motivates me, you know. So to me, this journey is not as special without them, you know. So I think the biggest thing for me is just finding that balance to where I'm spending, you know, the quality time with them, because when I have roles coming up, and again, you know, man, when you're getting deep into some of those roles, sometimes you kind of have to isolate, you know, just so you can do it. It's kind of hard to be yourself in your normal, you know, just in your normal world and bring that character to life how you need to. So shout out to wifey, man, Candace Curry Williams. You know, we're coming up on, 13 years married in November. So, you know, we met at UCF and everything, modeled together, you know. So that's my wifey for lifey. But yeah, I know,
Ty. Yeah, we're spoiling it for the single lady. It's all over social media. What do you want me to do?
It's good.
Not
good.
It,
but that's go ahead, brother.
Married. Denzel Washington married. They still lust over them. So that's okay.
Don't worry about it. I wasn't saying nothing about him being married. It was the modeling shit. I was going to get off his mouth.
We did runway modeling, you know, the spins, pivots, all that cool spins. Yeah, runway, you know. And I took my shirt off a lot, actually, with that. That's how I got my wife. You know, so.
Congratulations, dog.
Thank you. But she does a lot of the planning, though, man. Like, a lot of these vacations and stuff that we go on, you know, she plans that stuff in advance. You know, she'll ask me, you know, what's my filming schedule? What do I have coming up? You know, so. It's like it's a team, you know, collaborative effort. So, you know, I give her a lot of credit for setting a lot of that stuff up to where I'm able to balance that and not get too caught up in the work, you know.
Yeah. Hey, man, I admire that. Teamwork does make the dream work. Congratulations to you having a life partner and, of course, your lovely family brother. And I wasn't mad that you were spoiled because I'm the only single guy on the show. It's all right. I had my chance. I did 7 years.
I got some backup for once.
For once, he got some backup on the marriage side. Yeah, no worries, man. I believe in monogamy. You know what I'm saying? It's cool. It's all right, dog. I did my time. Congratulations, though, brother. Congratulations, man. The fact that you're able to juggle marriage, being a successful actor, was my man, S.S. O'Brien here. I just want to say this, man. What do you have to say to young, up-and-coming actors? I know you're a young guy in the game, but you done put some time in. What would you say to somebody just starting out, man? What is your advice to a newcomer?
So, my advice, man, I mean, I keep it 100 with people. You know, I would say, man, do it for the love of the craft. You know, I think, you know, what we're seeing today, you see this big impact that social media has had on the industry. And, you know, I think it's creating this false narrative that you don't have to put in work. If you just get a whole bunch of followers and stuff like that, then you can walk your way right onto a set. That may be the case, but it's like, I want to get to that point. I want to stay there, you know, and the only way you stay at that level is by putting on quality performances, you know, understanding the craft and, you know, enjoying the work. So, you know, everyone can add their 15 minutes of fame, but I think I don't want young people to get caught up in that. You know, grow your social media and everything, but learn the craft and don't do it for the money. Don't do it for fame. Do it for the love of the craft. And I'm telling you, it's going to be more rewarding, man, because when you do it for some of those other reasons, I promise you, man, like I know I've known people who've done it for that stuff. And I feel like their performances, man, are very flat. You know, like you see it in the performances, like you can see it. It's like they only want it. They only want social media love. You know, so it's like they post this, post this, post this, post this. But it's like, what does your work look like, though? You know, what are you getting better? Are you evolving as an actor? So I would say just don't never devalue the point of hard work, you know, and always working on your craft, you know, work on a monologue, get you a monologue, study on that, get into a class, you know, Essex and I were in OAA.
Life of an Actor. Say, this portion of the program is sponsored by Life of an Actor. Shout out to Chris Grant if you watch it, man. You sound just like him, brother. You sound just like him. But no, you have to.
We train, though. We train, man. You know, and you know, we constantly put ourselves in front of, you know, in a position to be judged, you know, on our performances. And it's like, you know, we get chopped up sometimes in class. We get chopped up, but it's like that's where you grow, though. You know, I'd rather get chopped up in class than to have a film come out. And you know, I'm thinking my stuff don't stink. And then it's like, man, the performance is flat. Like, I can't live with bad performances, man. I just can't. Yeah. You know, so that'll shorten your career real quick.
Absolutely.
And I've seen the growth too. And yeah, I forgot to mention that in the introduction. Troy and I are classmates as well. Like, and you know, that was not just being the joke, but yeah, Life of an Actor Studios with Chris Green. I've seen the growth since, you know, seeing some of your stuff since we've been friends on social media and now being in class with you. You see the growth and the stuff that you're talking about where people skip that step. Mm-hmm. That's what you notice when you start seeing people in project after project, but there's no growth. Mm-hmm. It's the same flat performance or the same, they can only be themselves or they can only do a certain lane of performance because there's no growth because there's not training. And you as an athlete, you know, if you ain't training, if you ain't in the gym, acting is a muscle as well, just like any bicep, tricep, deltoid. It's something that you have to get worked out and worked on constantly. And I'll be first to admit, I took that for granted when I first started as well. And I tried to coast a little too long on natural talent. But when my goals started to increase and I started to really see what I could do, that training became a must. So whether it's, you know, not just with Chris Green, with Dennis Neal, you know, whoever, you know, Russ Blackwell, actors, if you're watching this, man, that training, you cannot neglect that at all. I just want to get that in real quick, man. Good stuff.
Gotcha. Big man.
I want to give a shout out to you too, Essex. Real quick, I just want to give a shout out to Essex, man. Like I said, when I first came on the scene, man, Essex was like, you know what I'm saying? Like, Essex was one of the biggest actors. He still is, like, in this area. You know, I remember doing King Charles, man. It's like, this man is like holding it down. He's booking movies and like, I'm like, how do you do that? He lives in Orlando, but he's booking in Tampa. He's booking, like, I see this man booking everywhere. So I'm like, man, like, these are people that I wanted to start associating with, you know, people who I seen who were further along that also share that same passion, you know. So he's been doing his thing. And I'm like, man, David Makes Man, you know, man, dude, just shout out to you, man. Like, you know,
ooh, yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Thank you, brother. I appreciate it.
Man, inspiration, though, because I see you doing your thing. And you were already at a higher level when I first started. And I'm like, to see you still evolving, man, like, I understand that that's like, it's work, man. That's passion. You know, yeah. I respect that.
Thank you, brother. I appreciate it. I really do.
Congratulations, really do. Man. Check my man out on David Makes Man on network.
Oh, yeah.
Hey, my question for you, Troy. Going forward, man, any big things we can look forward to, man, with you? New projects coming up?
Make sure you answer that question. I was holding that, Monique, so that I knew we was going to get to that.
What platform is Limelight?
Make sure they know where they can find Limelight and all your social media, all the good stuff.
So they can see it. It's on my YouTube channel, in which I'll share that with you guys. But you can just type in Troy D. Williams. It'll come right up. And it's also on my public Facebook page. I post the episodes on there as well. And that's actor Troy D. Williams 941, or it's just Thoroughbred Films, LLC. You can check it on there. But yeah, I post it on my main Facebook page, and I promote it on Instagram as well. And I direct people to where they can watch the full episodes. So yeah, thank you for asking that question. But as far as projects coming up, I just wrapped on a feature film, man. I'm super excited about it. It's called The Book, False Prophet. And I had the honor of playing a pastor, you know, which is somewhat based on a true story. By far the role that has stretched me the most thus far in my career.
That's when you was Pastor Jack, right?
Yes, yes.
Can you tell us a little bit without spoiling it about what that character is about?
I can. So, kind of basically your modern day, you know, just think mega church, you know, pastor that's you know, in it for the wrong reasons and not just doing the Lord's work. Just kind of think that, you know. So,
Mom,
yeah.
He's trying to get into some pulpits, huh?
So it's wild, man. It's a wild story. Shout out to Betty Humphrey Breeden and Kenethia Mitchell. They did this as a stage play multiple times, and then they decided to turn it into a feature film, you know. And you know, I appreciate the opportunity of them casting me, and you know, it was a pleasure working with them because they gave me, which this is very rare. Essence can attest to it. It's very rare that directors will give you full creative control over your character. Like that doesn't happen too often,
right?
You know, it doesn't happen to unless you're like producing as well, you know, and then you pretty much count it by default. But they gave me full creative control over the character, man. So I felt free to just really explore, you know, just explore different things, man. So I'm like, when I say I hit some ranges that I didn't even know would, you know what I'm saying? Like I found out a lot of new things about myself in playing this character. So, I'm excited for people to see it, man. I know it's officially in post-production right now. My man Bojack, it was the director of photography on it. I love, man, it's another time working with him, one of the best DPs in the game right now. Real you know, good. So yeah, you know, that red camera, man. I feel like I'm spoiled now. I can't shoot with nothing but the red. You know what I'm saying?
Oh yeah.
It's gonna be coming out, man. I think toward the end of summer, maybe September, October time frame. I don't know the exact date, but I'm thinking just based on how post-production usually goes, I'm thinking somewhere around there. So we'll have, I'm sure, a big red carpet premiere for the city. And, you know, hopefully we'll hit multiple cities. But I'm very excited about that film, man. Very excited about it.
Congratulations.
Tell the name of the film again.
It's called The Book, False Prophet.
The Book, False Prophet. Okay. Yeah. And you play a pastor in there. That's good.
Yes. All right. And then one more thing I have coming up at the end of this month, I'll be doing my very first stage play. So it's called He Loves Me Not. It's going to be up in Groveland, Groveland, Florida. And we have a show Friday evening on the 30th. And then we have two shows on Saturday the 31st, 2 p.m. and 6 p.m. So, yeah, man. Shout out to Dr. Calandria Smith. She wrote it, directed it, and is producing it. And yeah, it's gonna be good. So I'm excited to touch the stage for the first time.
Great, man. Hey, you're gonna like that, man. Every actor worth his salt has to do some stage. I don't care where it is, how it is. Well, yeah, how, yes, do the right type of plays. But yes, no mama done burnt the beans plays and da 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 die slow quick. No. Do some real good plays. It ain't got to be Shakespeare, but, man, do some good plays.
Grandma burnt the beans. Don't do no more Grandma burnt the beans. Pastor ran away with his sister. I got you, though. That is
funny. Yeah, man. No, that's good stuff, man. Yeah, we got to do a little sports talk, man. We got an athlete on here. You know what I'm saying? We be chopping it up in class about sports anyway, man.
Oh, yeah. It'd be good. We be getting it in, man.
Yeah. The finals is about to start, man. How you think these finals going to shape out, man?
I'm going to say this, man. If Milwaukee don't win both of these games at home, it's over in five. Or they may get swept. Like Phoenix is just looking like the more superior team, man. When I seen Giannis score 42 last game and they still lost by double digits, I'm like, man. I'm like, Phoenix just is a lot better than what I think anyone thought they were, you know, and now they're coming together at the right time. And their coach, Monty Williams, man, like, dude, that coaching, he's really out coaching the dude on Milwaukee. Like, it's really coming down to that, the execution, the plays he's drawing up, the strategy. I'm like, he's coaching, man. Like, that's so when you got the talent and the coach, that's a machine. That's the combination for winning the championship.
Yeah, I'm with you on that one, man. I'm with Phoenix in five or six. Chris Paul's been at this for 21 years, bro. He is hungry. Devin Booker is amazing. I played a two guard and a three, small forward in high school, but mostly one and two in college. And junior college, I just let the record show that I averaged 3 points in 2 minutes. Just let the record show that. North Florida Junior College down in Madison, Florida. I raised a little hell before I got to FAMU and dropped out. So look here. Phoenix in six.
I averaged 10 rebounds at FSU Park over there by Leeds. That's never.
Let me tell you, hey man, I'm the all-time leading scorer outside in any outside rec center in Tallahassee. There's my name on a lot of rec center walls right now and faces. But yeah, I got Chris Paul in 5 or 6 because Phoenix is determined, and Devin Booker is a flat-out monster. I seen him do it. He a monster, bro. And he play on both ends. I got to give him credit. He play a little defense too. So I just like the way Phoenix looking right now.
I also led LA Fitness in 3-point field goal percentage. Don't worry about that. I agree, man. I think it's Chris Paul's year. I think it's his time. I think Milwaukee, they a little too system-y. You know what I'm saying? Like Giannis is their only true baller that can, like, whatever he want, whenever he want. Everybody else seem like, if the system gets out of whack, they're not going to bring nothing extra to overcome it. You know what I'm saying? Whereas Phoenix, to me, they got the dogs. Not just with, like y'all mentioned, with CP and Book, but, Campaign and Aiden, they got the athletes. They got guys that will just go over the top of you, get a rebound, dunk on you, outrun you to a loose ball. They got that them intangibles over Milwaukee, in my opinion. I think it's going to set them out. So I do think Milwaukee's going to win tonight, though. I think they're going to win tonight. And then, like y'all say, 5 or 6 games, it's a wrap for the Suns.
I'm with you. I'm with you on that, man. I do like Chris Middleton, too, for Milwaukee. But I'm with you. They just don't have enough dogs. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
To get to the next level, you need a dog. You know what I'm saying? So, and every team, you can think back through the history of the NBA. There's always been that one player that people ain't really like, but he was a dog. He fought hard. He was angry. He really wanted it. LeBron wanted it because Steph Curry and them beat him 2 or 3 times. He really wanted it, that one championship. I'll never forget that. I was in Miami, and we was like, wow, them boys took the Clippers to – well, not the Clippers. Took them to overtime. Steph Curry, the Warriors, to overtime. LeBron really wanted it. You know what I'm saying? You can tell it was in his heart. He wanted it. But, hey, I love it, man. Football, NFL's coming up, bro. Who your team, Troy?
Well, see, I'll be honest, man. Like, nowadays, I don't really have a team, man. Like, I mean, I'll just root for the Bucks since they're here in Florida, you know. Yeah. But, I don't really have a team. If a team who I would love to see go far and stay healthy, the Cleveland Browns, man. Like, I like what they have going. Like, that, like, if a team that I would play with on Madden, it would probably be Cleveland Browns because I like what they have going. They have all the elements. If they can stay healthy, especially Odell, most importantly, he can stay healthy, man. I think they could go all the way this year.
I like Cleveland too. You the Dolphins, am I right, young man?
I do like the Dolphins. I ain't gonna lie, I kind of fell off on football a little bit. But I grew up rooting for the Dolphins, and I kind of like started following players that came from the U and liking some of their teams as like my second and third team. So I like the Ravens. You know what I'm saying? I like whatchamacallit? It was on the tip of my tongue. I used to like the 49ers back in the day. So, you know, stuff like that. I like the college football now more myself. I follow that a little closely myself because of Canes. And then, you know, I live with a rival in here with them Seminoles, you know what I'm saying? So when the fall come around, that's prime shit talking around this house, you know what I'm saying? And then just to go to the game sometime. I actually went to a nice game one time. Just, I think, random.
You went to the bounce house? Yeah.
Yeah, just random, you know, on a random, just living here, just going over there. It's a nice stadium over there. Mm-hmm. Yeah, y'all playing in nice facilities, man.
Man, they call it the bounce house, man. That thing be bouncing when they start jumping, man. That whole thing be shaking, man. It's an experience.
Oh, yeah.
And they've actually been pretty good. Did Josh Heupel leave? Did the coach leave at UCF?
Yeah. We just got the one coach from Auburn. What's his name? He wears the glasses.
Gus Malzahn.
Yeah. So we good.
All right.
We good. All right. Recruiting about to get better. I really didn't like Heupel, man. I didn't like him. Like, he inherited I feel like he inherited a good thing, but it's like, I feel like, dude, like that hurry up offense, like that fast paced up tempo. I'm like, all right, once you're up 30, now you got to start controlling the clock. Because if we keep going 3-4 and out and we're doing passes and the clock is not running, teams are having time to come back. I didn't understand it, man. It made no sense from a strategic standpoint.
No, not at all. And then y'all had Scott Frost. I don't know how y'all lost Scott Frost, but that was just –
He was alma mater. He was a quarterback for Nebraska, so they offered him, like, more money. And then I think he had just had a baby. He and his wife had just had their first kid, so his parents were there. So, you know, kind of having a babysitter for the kid, it was just everything made sense for him to go there. So we knew we had no chance, man. It was the best thing for him.
Yeah. I guess. Is that your wife chiming in?
Yeah, no. Say hello to Mrs. Williams. I hope you didn't miss your husband just gave you some beautiful flowers a moment ago. So I hope you didn't miss it. But welcome to the show. Say hello to Mrs. Ferguson. We got to get y'all together one day. Forget you, Johnny. Don't be talking about my team like that. You ain't so far away.
Hey, man.
Hey, what's going on, Sharon? How you doing?
Hey, congratulations, Sharon. Hey, Ida. Hey, man, congratulations on all your success, Troy. I hope to be one day in a movie with you, bro. I know I do stand up. I'm in a whole nother lane. I'm definitely, Essex keep trying to get me to start doing this acting thing, and we done wrote a couple of skits.
Really? Y'all got all that green screen in the studio over there at Afro. I've been waiting for the call. I'm going to just have to go and start knocking on the door with some scripts and tell, what's your homeboy? I'm sorry, his name is escaping me, but the brother over there I always talk to when I go.
James?
No, not your.
Shanti?
Yeah. Not James.
Shanti shoot movies and short films and things like that.
I'm going to go over there with my scripts. Y'all get the cameras ready, and let's just shoot something, man. Let's get it done.
Hey, it's so much going on in there, man. We're definitely going to get you going.
Y'all shoot videos.
Congratulations. Congratulations. I'm not listening to Essex no more. Congratulations, Troy, on all your success, bro, on the lovely family, man. Just on behalf of brothers all over the world, man, the fact that you're a black man that got a family and you're doing right and you taking care of your family, man, let me just salute you right now in the age and time of divorce and foolishness and ignorance and Twitter and twerking. And I just want to salute you, man, for being a brother that's holding his family together, because everybody can't do that. You know what I'm saying? And I did 7 years and I'm out. And the fact that you had 13, congratulations that you made it to 13, you and Miss Candace there. And y'all continue to be a model. All right. And behalf of single people all over the world, don't be trying to hook your single friends up. Let us make our own mistakes. Don't try to hook. That's married people always try to hook you up. Let us make our own mistakes and we shall find a way.
Y'all, hey, I appreciate all that, man. Y'all
fighting too hard anyway out there, man. You're fighting too hard. Sorry, hey, it's already
right now, man.
It's just gonna be a white not
a single, man. The game has changed.
Yes.
Hey, I be lost, man. I'm like, dude. I be talking about single homeboys, man. I'm like, dude. It's rough out there in the streets right now,
man. Bro.
Hey, it's like buying a used car, bro. It's tough out here, man. You just don't know. It's something wrong. It take a minute to find out, but something is wrong. It take a minute sometimes. So I'm gonna just resort to dating the old women in the church. I know what I'm getting, dog. At least I'm gonna get something to eat and keys to the church van. I can count on that.
I was just gonna say, at least you're gonna get some good yams, some good potato salad out of that thing.
Consistency is what I'm in search of.
Dude, you had a joke the other night about taking the damn dentures out. They had me rolling. I know you really did that for real in real life.
Absolutely, brother. We'll talk about that another time. You're not going to ruin Troy's night. And his beautiful relationship with me and dating my mama friends. We're not going to start that. Dating some of my mama friends conversation. We're not going to talk. We're going to come back. Troy, I'm going to write a script.
Save it for the special.
I'm gonna save it for the next special. Hey, man. Troy, I'm gonna write a script, man, and we hope to get you in one of our skits. Me and Essex doing, and continued success to you, brother.
Hey, run your social media down one more time, Troy. And then we'll let you go, man. We appreciate you, brother. I knew this would be a good show, and you lived up to the billing, my brother.
Yeah,
appreciate you, man. So yeah, y'all can follow me on Facebook, Troy D. Williams. On Instagram. So my main Instagram just got hacked, and I'm kind of pissed about that because I had some sponsorship deals in place, and I had like 16,000 followers on there.
Yeah. Hold on, Troy, before you finish, I did want to ask you about that. You have a very impressive social media following. Is there any tricks to the trade? Because, you know, I be struggling. I can't get a motherfucker to click a link sometimes. How do you get so many followers? Do you know the algorithm, man? Do you got his phone number? Like, what are you doing, brother?
I'll be honest, man. Zuckerberg, he's kind of messed it up, man. Like, Like I have a lot of my Facebook is always been my strongest one just because I've had it since college, you know, since like 04. I've had it since 04. So all the people, like I'm at 5,000, I'm kind of maxed out at 5,000 on there, but it's like, I pretty much know all those people. Like I've crossed past them at some point in life.
Okay.
Whereas Instagram is like, you know what I'm saying? It's just the world, you know? So you have people that are overseas, you have stuff like that. They just follow you. So one thing I can say, man, is like I said, people can tell when you're keeping it 100, you know, it's all really all about the story, man, the journey. People like to see progress. So I keep my pages very positive. You know, I try to stay away from certain topics, you know, as much as I can, you know, the controversial stuff. I try to stay away from as much as I want to say something on them, but some of the stuff I don't, because I feel like it's not their best platform. You know, I feel like, you know, just kind of sometimes talking and settings like this, you know, sometimes you can educate people a lot more, where sometimes people on social media, they have pride, you know, so they close their ears to, even if you're telling them facts, you know, they have pride and they have their following, so they have to show out for them as well. So, you know, I stay away from stuff like that and I just keep it positive, man. They see it as my family. What they see is what they get, you know, and, you know, I don't talk about it. I be about it. So, you know, through actions, people can just see the growth. And I think that's really what like acting and then working out as well. Fitness is another big industry. Like it hits on the algorithm in Instagram big time. So just me hitting the gym and stuff like that. And then my acting is like the perfect combination. So that's where I get most of my followings from, is that.
Awesome. Okay, so I got to go to the gym and stop being a dick. Okay, gotcha.
Yes, exactly.
Yeah, so
the old
profile was actor Trady Williams 941. That's my big one on Instagram. I'm still working with Instagram to get it back. But for the time being, I have a backup page, which is just Troy D. Williams. It's at Troy D. Williams on Instagram. On Twitter, it's at Troy Williams 941. And then YouTube, like I said, it's Troy D. Williams. And then you can IMDb me, Troy D. Williams. And then also you can check on Amazon Prime. I have a couple of films on there as well. So just go to Google, man. Google, everything will come up. All my links, everything. Troy D. Williams.
Yes, yes, yes. And help your fellow actors and artists. When he says that, do it. It helps us. I just got hip to this too, Troy. The Google thing and then the IMDb, like how people find you on IMDb. That makes your number and make you more visible. Like that's a real thing. So yeah, when we tell y'all to support us and click these links and all that, that stuff really does add up and it really does matter. So y'all go and y'all Google this man, just like the name says, Troy D. Williams. Hit us up all the social media, follow him, like him, share him, all that good stuff, man. What Joni say? She say, "Well, so much for that." Shut up! Nobody asked you. It's your fault. Anyway. Thank you, brother. We appreciate you being here. Ty, did you have anything else to join? Did you have anything else, Ty?
No, I'm good, man. Thanks again, Troy. 941 in the building, man. Shout out to Brady,
baby. 941. I appreciate y'all, man. I love what you guys are doing, man. Thank you guys for having me on the show.
Yeah, hang out backstage real quick, man. Be right with you. Ty, what you got going on, man?
Hey, man, of course, Funny Not Famous coming up this Tuesday. Shooting our last two specials, and then we get right back into the television show. Hey, man, then it's vacation time, brother. Vacation all next week, man. Just trying to relax and unwind. But check us out this Wednesday. Actually, come on out to the studio, 7220 International Drive here in Orlando. Watch a live taping of the Lowdown with James John. It's this Wednesday from about 1 to 3. Matter of fact, I'm sorry, from about 12 to 2, we'll be taping live. We're looking for a live studio audience. Come on out there and be a part of it. Our first time having a live audience in the building.
Nice. That's good, man. Hey, it's been busy for me this summer. It's like night and day from last summer when COVID was kicking everybody's butt. I just got through wrapping a feature film called A Time for Every Purpose, where I played a very key pivotal role in that. You know what I'm saying? Shout out to what Troy was saying earlier about putting that work in and getting these character roles down. I love it. I'm going to be shooting a commercial over in Clearwater later this week. So very exciting times. If you guys saw us from the beginning, you saw my appearance on David Makes Man. I'm sure you can find it on demand, wherever on demand shows are. And you can find my 15 seconds of fame. Oh, yeah. You know what I'm saying? Go check it out. You know what I'm saying? Oh, make a post, take a picture, tag me, do something. And we appreciate it, man. Thank y'all for joining us. Thank you, Troy, again. Thank you for all everybody that's watching on YouTube and Facebook. Make sure you like, subscribe to the YouTube channel as well as the Facebook page for Actin Funny, man. Essex O'Brien on Facebook and Twitter, at Actor Man Essex on Instagram. What else you got, Tyke?
Hey, that's it, man. Tyke Mike Comedy on all your social platforms. Tyke Mike Comedy. All right. Talk to you later, man. Hey, thanks, brother. Thanks,
everybody. Thank you very much.
Peace.